Happy hump day. It's Wednesday and we're at the sawmill. And Gary's our sawyer today. We've got Alan there rolling logs. You may notice that little red thing right above Gary's head, Gary's guy with the orange hat on, is a new hoist we put up. Not quite tweaked up yet. We've got a little bit of work on it yet. But that'll be rolling the logs pretty soon, we hope. And we've got Pete helping do the offload. We've got Tom doing offload. And what we're going to do today is make some tomato steaks. We know it's only January, but what a great time to make tomato steaks. We're going to stock them up this time. This will have plenty of tomato steaks for everybody for the summer. So what Gary's doing here, we're adjusting the set works a little bit. Tomato steaks traditionally are 1.5 inches by 1.5 inches by, well, I don't know, 5 foot or something like that. Depends whether you grow cherry tomatoes or you grow beefsteak tomatoes. Cherry tomato steaks are not as big as beefsteak tomato steaks. Pretty funny, huh? But he's adjusted the set works a little bit. So when he does one pull, he gets a little bit less than 1.5 inches. And that way it fits our pencil sharpener down the other end, which you will see very shortly. So we've gotten a couple of comments. Boy, you guys could be a little bit more efficient. You're wasting a little bit of lumber there. Well, yeah, we probably are. So here's the story. All the slab wood gets taken away, especially in the wintertime, gets taken away fast because people in our county use the slab wood for heating, and it's a good thing. Additionally, we've got more flipping red oak than we know what to do with. So if we have a little bit goes to waste, throw it out. Just in case you didn't know, what Gary is doing here, he's making a big cant. But why do we keep sending these boards back that are like 1.5 inches by whatever they are? Well, he's going to send those back for a resaw. Because to resaw, we want 1.5 inch tomato steaks. So he's going to send 2 or 3 of these back till he gets a nice size cant. And then he'll stack them up 3 or 4 at a time. And then we'll whip out tons of tomato steaks very quickly. it's taken this much time to get to the point where we can finally start stacking some of these boards up. And I don't know what he's going to do, 3 or 4 of these at a time here. And then we'll start whacking out some tomato steaks pretty quickly. So, and then, of course, when they get to the other end, we'll have to sharpen them. And after we sharpen them, we'll have to cut them in half. Or maybe we'll cut them in half, then we'll sharpen them, because they're 10-foot long boards. So what we're doing now here, you've got me in the red shirt, you've got Tom and Tom. We're taking some of the slab wood. Tom's taking a little bit of it home. We've got the other Tom, and he's bringing back some of the 5-foot tomato stakes so we can sharpen these stakes, and then we'll be on with the project. And what we want to do is we'll save up 100 stake bundles, and then we'll be ready to get rid of them in the spring. And for you especially observant people, you've probably noticed some of these stakes were a little bit rotten on coming off, and now they broke, actually. And that's what Tom's doing. He's throwing them out, and we use them for firewood. Well, thanks for watching Wayne's World Garage. Stand by. We got a couple more videos coming out in the next couple days. A little bit of a show of our dust collection system and how that's working out. And how's that log roller working out?